Hello to all retail traders and welcome to Easy Trading with Weis Wave with Speed Index. Today we're going to show lesson 8, which is two very simple but at the same time very powerful speed index patterns. The reason I decided to make this video is to help out all these traders that are trading with Weis Wave with Speed Index. And let's see what are we going to see today. So the contents of this video will be the explanation of the index patterns, which a fellow trader from UK and a friend of mine, Richard, named them Plutus and Plutus Reversal. Thank you, Richard, for the names. After that, we're going to demonstrate these patterns on actual charts. So let's start. Pattern number one, Plutus. This is when price will go in the direction of the high speed index wave. So if we look at here, the conditions that have to be met are, for a long trade, we need to have a slow up wave of a few bars, at least 3 bars, especially in 1 hour charts, with a high speed index and a high volume with small pip move. In the example on the right, you will see it. So the first condition is high speed index. It's at 23.6, as you can see here. At the same time, we have volume, but small pip move. And the second condition is that we're going to have a fast down wave with a low speed index that never breaks support. Okay, it might break it a little bit and then come back in again. So in this case, we are drawing support and resistance that have been formed from these two waves. And if the price breaks resistance, we're going long. Very simple. So for a short trade, again, Plutus pattern is exactly the opposite. The price will go again in the direction of the high speed index wave. So what do we have? We have a slow down wave of a few bars with a high speed index, this 25 right here. And we can see also we have a high volume and small pip move. The second condition, we have a fast up wave which with a low speed index, a 5.1 in this case. So we're drawing support and resistance out of these two waves. And if the price breaks support, then we're going short. Okay, we're going short only if it breaks support. The second pattern is Plutus reversal. It's exactly the opposite. This is when price will go in the opposite direction of the high speed index wave. And for a long trade, the following conditions must be met. So what are we going to have here? We're going to have one, a fast up wave. In this case, this up wave here with the 4.6, okay? Then we have a slow down wave with a high speed index, that's a 26.1. And as you can see again down here at the market, but it's visible, high volume, not pip move. We draw support and resistance levels, and as long as we break resistance, we're going long. And this is what happened. And the opposite of that for a short trade is the following. We have a fast wave down, that means a low speed index, that's 7.9 right here. Then a slow up wave with a high speed index, 50.4 it's very easily identified, and at the same time large volume, no big move, very small. We're drawing again support and resistance levels, and in this case we can see that the support of 7.9 is also support from previous bars. So as long as we break support, we're going short, and this is what is going to happen. Okay, it went short and it went quite a while. The methodology for these two patterns. First, identify a high speed index wave, then a low speed index wave. That's a Plutus pattern. Or in the opposite order, a low speed index wave and a high speed index wave. That's a Plutus reversal. So this is what I mean. High speed index, low speed index. Then draw support and resistance out of those two waves, or it might be in confluence with other waves previously. After that, we need to check that also the high speed index wave has high volume but small peak move. Right? And then we enter accordingly if the pattern is Plutus or Plutus reversal, when it breaks support or resistance, depending on the case. So in that case, we had this high speed index wave, then a fast one up with 3.5, that's a Plutus pattern for a short trade if it breaks the support level. Of course, confluence at these levels with FIB or other support resistance increases probability. Now, let's go to the actual demonstration. I've marked in some of these charts when this happens, so we can do this together. Okay, I just marked the points. So what do I see here? First of all, okay, I see a high speed index here and a very fast one here. All right, let me delete this. So I'm drawing resistance and support. Okay. Now, resistance could be all the way up to here. All right, then out of this wave we can draw support, which you can see that this is can be extended all the way down to here. So this is a Plutus pattern long. Let me write this down. Only if it breaks resistance. Okay. And as you can see, it did break resistance and we went up. And another thing, okay, the volume of the high speed index wave with the pips. Down here the volume is higher than the pips, not so significant, but with all this background, this will be a long trade after it breaks. So what it will be my stop loss? My stop loss will be below the support level, okay, because this thing might range for a while. Okay, let's go on. This place up here, which is a trend reversal. This is what happened. This is a Plutus reversal trade, which means price will go against the high speed index wave. So what do we do here? We draw support and resistance. So support here, I will draw it all the way to this level, right? And resistance up to here, since I have this point. Okay, then we will see this up wave, the volume is this, while the pip move, it's only this small. This pattern is a Plutus reversal. Which means price will go in the opposite direction of the high speed index. And as we go along, the funny thing is that we see a Plutus pattern, which is this one. That's the high speed index wave, and that's the low speed index wave. So we got a 32.1 and a 6.6. And this is a Plutus pattern. Okay, this is a Plutus short. Okay, while this one was a Plutus reversal short. So we got two shorts. So what do we do? As long as we break resistance, we enter short. And the result is visible. This is 528 pips down. Okay, let's go to another one. Let's go to UJ. You see what I have marked here. All right. Ah, something that I forgot. The indicators using is the same as all the times. This is the pip wave. This is Weis wave with speed index. And this is no demand, no supply, with weighted volume. So another case we see here, we have a 3.1 and a 20.2. draw our support and resistance. So support is here, as you can see, it's also coming from here. So there is confluence, which is a much better probability. And if we want to be 100% sure that this is a long trade, instead of drawing resistance to this level, we can even draw it all the way up to this level. Okay. Furthermore, this is the volume wave, and this is the pip move, much smaller. So this is a very nice Plutus reversal. Sorry, long. All right. So depending from where we entered our entry, if we enter it from here all the way up to here, it's 347 pips. But as you can see, we went down and previous resistance became support and we start going up again. So that's 500 pips. Another example on GJ. Okay, two examples here. All right. Very simple. Identify the extremes of two consecutive waves. One fast wave, slow wave. Draw resistance and support. Okay, at the same time, we will draw, this is a huge up wave with a very small pip move. So this trade is short if we break support, which we did, and this pattern, I will write again, it's a Plutus reversal short, which means that the price will go in the opposite direction of the high speed index. And we went down. pips. And this is what happened later on when the trend reversed. Okay. So what do we got here? We got two patterns at the same time, but the last one, it's always, I will show you here. Okay. This is a fast down move, a slow up move, which signifies the same story as the Plutus reversal short, but we never broke resistance. So it doesn't quite fit our story. But what you're gonna see now is that after this formation, we got exactly this formation, this 34.5 with a 6.8, which is again a fast move. Okay, so in this case, sorry, I forgot to draw resistance up here. All right, so in this case, we had a possible Plutus reversal short, which never happened because we never broke resistance. And after this, we're having a Plutus long, which means price will go in the direction of the high speed index, which is the 34. So as long as we break resistance, we're going long. And this is what I did. And what I forgot to draw, it's this, which again, one more time, it's volume with small pip move. Let's go to the next one. AU. There we go. Right here. Low speed index, which means a fast wave. High speed index, which means a slow wave. Draw support, draw resistance, could be here, could be also here, it could also be here, drawn, but since we never able to get it another level, so what is this pattern? This is a Bluetooth reversal short. Okay. And we will draw this volume a bit more, not so visible here, but still it worked out pretty well. So as long as we break resistance, we're going short, and that was almost 400 pips. One more. These patterns are everywhere and every day. Okay. That's New Zealand USD, one here. Four, low speed index, 17.4 high speed index. It's four times the difference. Then the volumes of the high speed index here, and the pip move. High volume, no pip move. Draw support resistance. Resistance here. Support. Here, so easily identified a Bluetooth reversal short. Okay, again, let me point out that price can go back into range. Our stop loss should be above this level. And we went into range, but then we went down. So this is about 571 pips. What I do, I place two orders. After it breaks, my first target will be a significant level like a fib or resistance, in this case, previous resistance. And then the second, then I will close that order with profits. And then the second order, I will run moving my stop loss. Okay, another one that might come up on Monday. And this is the case. We have a high, fast wave, slow speed index. And the high speed index down here, not so high yet, but this is forming, so we don't know where it's gonna end up. So I will draw this as a resistance, and whatever this wave finishes, support. Let's say that this was the end of it. So this is a Bluetooth reversal long if we break this resistance level. So as I said, you will find all these patterns every day in many instruments. Very, very simple, very, very powerful at the same time. Let me go back to the presentation. So thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe because more videos will follow. If you're interested in this method of trading, you can download the demos, of course, from MQL5. The indicators are available for MT4 and MT5. Especially look my MQL5 blog at this address, because here is where I post my forecasts and before and after pictures, if the forecast succeeded or not. Well, most of the time succeeds. And thank you for watching for one more time. Bye bye.